We're honored to introduce a leader who has dedicated his life to build this unity and to fight for transport workers around the globe. His passion, commitment, and leadership have been instrumental in shaping our movement. Please join us to welcome IETF President and National Secretary of the Maritime Union of Australia, Paddy Crumlin.
Paddy Crumlin, ladies and gentlemen. I get knocked down, but I get up again.
Thank you, Brother Melody and the UMT, for sharing this wonderful culture, the generosity of spirit. I've been lucky to sit next to Bilal, who's been translating many of the songs. They're about songs about courage, songs about death, songs about freedom, songs about joy, songs about human beings in Arab nations fighting for what's good and remembering and celebrating and working together. And the translation is, in one hand I hold the olive branch of peace, and over my shoulder I carry the body of my brother or sister. And that's what it is. It's a struggle for freedom here in Morocco. 1955, since the shackles of colonialism was shrugged off. And yet we see this vibrant democracy and involvement and recognition of trade unions and working men and women that are embedded in the Moroccan life. So thank you, Brother Melody, for your and your teams, because unionism is a collective. It's about all of us. We don't lose our individualism by coming together and finding consensus. We build our spirit, and in building our spirit, we build our world. We build all of the opportunities that come along with it. The union movement is the home of a thousand, a million, a billion hopes and aspirations. We're a political movement, as well as an industrial movement, and a human movement, and a human rights movement, and a movement of compassion and empathy, and courage and determination. I get knocked down, I get up again. Nothing gonna keep me down. And we're a movement where no one gets left behind. In a world where there's two types of power, there's the power of elitism, and greed and selfishness, of mindless accumulation, regardless of the cost. That's power. It's a power of ruthlessness. It's a power to be able to separate yourself from your actions to their outcomes. That's the power of capital. Unregulated, raw capital. The power to separate one worker from another worker. Men against women on the basis of race and ethnicity, on age, so that that power can consolidate itself, because our power is a different type of power. It's not the power to feed greed or ignore pain and injustice. It's not the power to misrepresent and vilify who we are as human beings. It's not the power to dismiss out of hand. It's not the power of cynical politicians that are circling each other in their own self-interest and political interest. It's the power of division and not unity. So our power, and you've heard it today, I don't have to reinforce it. And this week is about building a different type of power. Not the power of the new right, the re-emergence of fascism, the ugliness of racism and misogyny. It's power in the face of that, that gets motivated by that injustice and pervasive injustice. We have the power to heal and to help, to not leave anybody behind. the power to help people realize their aspirations, to build their homes and their families, the power to have health and long life, the power to have dignity and decency on the job, regardless of what part of the geography of the world you come from. The power and the vision that we are all the same. The power to want to integrate Africa, and Stephen's referred to it, into the world economy. To defeat poverty. To defeat war. To build a sense of empathy and sympathy amongst ourselves, so someone else's pain is our pain. Someone else's trouble is our trouble. And regardless of where you come from in the world or what your gender is or what your religions or belief is, that we're human beings together in this mighty movement, political movement, that is the great hope of humanity to be able to get that sustainability that Stephen referred to and Mary referred to shrug off the lies of climate denialism, to realise that we haven't got politicians or companies or multinationals that are determined to go the distance in the preservation of our humanity and our environment. To be able to have investment based on the needs of workers and the recognition of freedom of association, the right to strike, as Stephen said. Not to go to the ILO, not to put laws in place to stop it. To understand that you have to struggle in a world where we have to struggle for freedom and justice, for decency, for dignity, for long life, for safety. Where contractors and casual workers are pitched against permanent workers. Why? Because they're cheaper. Where modern slavery is still pervasive in the shipping industry. Where social dumping happens all the way across Europe and across the world in the trucking industry. Where privatisation is to take away the community's assets and sell it back to us. And if it goes broke, to get our tax dollars to go and buy it again. And meanwhile, there are companies that won't even pay the 15% OECD tax and do their best on billionaires. What's a billion? 50 billion, 100 billion. Who are these guys? Musk. I mean, what is that? The need to be immortal. Rupert Murdoch, the press and the vilification, billionaires that are submerged in their own moral corruption. And that we come here in Morocco, and thank you again to the UMT to be able to realise a better world. See, this is our world. The world of transport workers that drive the economy, that work in the face of exploitation and abandonment at sea. Dock workers that never come home to their families due to a failure to regulate and protect them on the job. Women that cannot get permanent employment because they can't work to shift work round the clock 7 days a week because they have families or they're single parents. And men. See, we live in the real world. This is the real world. This is the Arab world also, where pain and suffering is raining down on innocents, men and women in Palestine and in Lebanon. Why? Because why? Because there aren't enough people like ITF people. Working people that are prepared to stand up and have the courage to work and fight for peace. Fight for peace, fight for dignity. That's our sympathy, that's our empathy. This is the power that we're proud of, ITF power. That's our power, union power. So I'm going to finish there and come down and bring us all together in this chant, this celebration with our voices, so that we can reinforce and find the foundation this week to put our words in this wonderful cultural expression and sharing and the generosity of it. We can embed it in our own internationalism, in our own sense of identity, And whenever we see freedom or wherever we're confronted with injustice, we can think of Morocco and we can think about the wonderful mentoring and leadership that we've had here today. So I'm going to go down, we're going to take a photo and we're going to raise the roof and we're going to say who we are. There's two chants, or there's two ways I'd like to put it, and that is firstly, who moves the world? I'll propose, and we'll get up and celebrate, for as Steve said, from our boots to the top of our hair if we've got it. We will celebrate, we move the world, and then we'll finish with one thing. I say union, and you say power. So let's go down, get ready for it, clear your throat, and they'll hear us all the way over to Palestine and Lebanon, down to South Africa, across to New Zealand, up to the Northern Hemisphere. They'll hear our voice and they'll know that we're coming for justice and peace and decent work for every human being and every worker. Thanks very much, brothers and sisters. Who moves the world?
We move the world.
Yeah, no, we can do better than that. Who moves the world? I say union, and you say power. Union!
Power.
Union!
Power.
Union!
Power.
Thanks very much. Have a great night.
Shukran.